Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, this is BestInSlot, and we are back with another episode of Jurassic World Alive, because we've got some things to do. Now, we've got lots to do here. So you can see my squad has leveled up a little bit, and I've actually got two new rare dinosaurs ready to join in. So the first one is the Utahraptor, which you guys just saw. It is very frustrating, because I wait. I want you guys to be there with me for the process, and it means I have to wait. Oh, you feathery little son of a gun, aren't you? I've got to say, the game has some good-looking dinosaurs. It genuinely does. Like, compared to Jurassic World, the game, I really think they've stepped it up. This is our Proceratosaurus. You ready? You ready? Look how fluffy it is. It's like a teddy bear that would eat your face, which is the dream. It seems that your rare dinosaurs actually start at level 6. That's really good. That means both of these are going to come straight away into the team. Now, the choice is, what do I remove? I think the stego... Oopsie daisy. Actually, before we do any of that, there's something else we need to do. You'll notice that I've been really busy working on just this. My Nandosuchus and my Majungasaurus are both level 5. I believe Majungasaurus has arrived. I believe. Yes, there we go. Fuse 20. I don't know if we get all the DNA necessary. I don't really know how this works. We're about to find out. Right, okay, now that looks really bad. That looks really depressing, right? It does, I get that. But it's not as depressing as it looks. So it seems like we get 20 DNA each time we do it. Okay, I was really wondering how this would work, because you only get one of each dinosaur. It's not like Pokemon Go, where you'd have like 200... We'd have like 500 Pidgeys, and you'd evolve 200 of them to make a Pidgeotto. I'm not saying those are the numbers, but that was the system. Whereas with this, you have one dinosaur and you level it up. So it seems what happens is, as soon as your dinosaurs get to level 5, your excess DNA on those species past that level 5 marker can be used to fuse the hybrid system. Alright folks, a little bit of an update. I have been a busy bee today. First things first, I'm just going to give you guys a little tip here. You'll see I've got actually quite a few more batteries and quite a few more darts than I had before. I've actually spent a load of them. What I've been doing, because obviously I can't buy anything with actual money, I've been going to the earn cash section of the cash little page and doing some of the challenges. Now, I tend to pick ones that reward between 60 to 90 because they tend to be less effort. But most of them, what they'll basically require is you go download some terrible, terrible game off the App Store. I've played some trash today, folks. I've played some bad games. But you play it for like half an hour whilst doing something else, and you hit like level 10 or whatever, level up your kingdom or some nonsense, and you'll unlock like 60 to 90 sort of in-game dino dollar thingies. It's actually been really helpful. It's let me kind of stack up a little bit and actually do some stuff for once. Got some stuff to do today in this little part of the episode. I am going to save the hybridization for the next episode. I say save, I can't quite do it. I need about 77 Majungasaurus DNA, I think, in order to make our hybrid. But we do have lots to do, so we can level up our raptor, as you can see right there. Actually, we're not going to do this, and I'll show you why in a second. Let's just go back. I have three brand new rare dinosaurs that I've collected across today that we're going to sort of create together. I've been wanting to use these in battles all day long, and I've not been able to because I wanted you guys to kind of experience it all together. So, first one, Megalosaurus. Kind of awesome looking, I think you guys will agree. That's a good looking little dinosaur right there. I'm kind of impressed. I'm actually really impressed. Let's have a look at some stats and stuff. Can I scroll down there? Ooh, Megalosuchus. Interesting. 800 health, 326 damage. Now that isn't much, but it does have a bleeding bite, which seems to be a powerful dot effect. I'm not that thrilled with this guy's stats, I've got to say. Not even that good speed. Okay, we also have a Tenontosaurus, I believe. Yep. Pretty cool. Look at that health. Look, see, the damage and the health is like the same, and it's quicker. It's so much better than the Megalosaurus. The balance in this game is non-existent. Some dinosaurs are substantially better than others. Look at that. That's insane. 75% chance to stun an opponent. And a 50%, that's actually a really good set of abilities right there. We're definitely including that one. But wait, there's more. Is this Nodosaurus? No, this is Wahoo-Wahoo-Wahoo-Saurus. My favourite saurus, the Wahoo-Wahoo-Wahoo-Saurus. There we go. Another really kind of beautiful looking model. This game doesn't have that many dinosaurs, all said, but I think they've put more care and attention into them. And again, look at those stats. Good speed, good health, good damage, 10% defense, way better than the Megalosaurus. Why does Megalosaurus suck? Instant cripple, that is a good move. So act first, target's damage is reduced 90% this turn. Wait, is that good? That seems rubbish. It doesn't do any damage. I don't like that. But that's okay, whatever. Majungasaurus would be... Oh my god, it's a Majungasaurus. I was all ready to do this in the next episode, but if I can get 77 DNA here, 7... No, like 6 perfect... I can't remember how much I get per hit. I think it's 13 now. We can actually make the hybrid right now. I think it's 77 we need, but we're about to find out. I'm not going to talk through this because I need to focus. We need a really good score here. Well, let's go. Is it enough? Yes! Max DNA collected. It started off at 70, then it hit 80. Now it's only 85, so it seems to be, maybe it'll be 90 for the next one. It seems to be slowing down a little bit. That should, in theory, if the system isn't too incredibly stupid, that will be enough DNA for us to get ourselves our very first hybrid dinosaur and hopefully go try it out. We're going to go test out the battle arena in a second because the Mount Sibo one is really cool. So you can see there, you need 70 DNA for both. You spend it, you fuse, and you get an amount towards the Majundasaurus. So I got 20. Oh, it's a random amount. Okay, I actually didn't know that. There we go. Create. Ladies and gentlemen, our first hybrid. That's a pretty cool looking dinosaur. Its stats suck. Its stats are terrible. It looks awesome. It looks like an absolute badass, but its stats are terrible. Why are the stats so bad? I'm curious now. It does have three... It has three bonus attacks, which is the most I've ever seen. But the stats are so bad! The health is really low, the damage is really low. I don't really like Lockdown Strike as an attack anyway. Bleeding Bite is okay, Cleansing Impact is... Okay, I'm not impressed, guys, I've got to say. It's a really cool-looking dinosaur. I really like the look of it. Very, very cool. But I don't think I'm going to... It's not coming into my team, I'll tell you that much. I think. Anyways, let's go try Mount Sibo. There's some actually really cool battle arenas in this. I've had to hold back a little bit. The battles aren't really proving that much of a problem for me yet. I think I'm a little bit ahead of where I should be, possibly. Although, it seems the opponent's... I don't know if the opponent's scale to you or if it's only based on the arena. Like, if you didn't battle at all, you stayed at the training ground, but you walked in with three epic dinosaurs, would your opponent... Anyways, look at that. It's Mount Sibo. Look at that. You can see this burning gyrocopter on the left-hand side cracked. This is it after it's gone off, you know? And we get to try out our wahoo, wahoo, wahoo. Look at the health total on this thing. Mad. Wait, this isn't my wahoo, wahoo. It's my Nodo? I think it's my Nodo. Didn't get any of my bloody new ones in this whole set. How stupid is that? Yeah, there's that burning gyrosphere, the lava coming down from Mount Sibo. It's awesome stuff. Like I've said before, I really rate the Ankylosaurids. I really do. Look, really good damage there as well. But it's got like a great defense as well. I'm about to get smashed, but... Oh. You want to use the defensive attack whenever possible. I was just hyping you up, Mr. Ankylosaur, and you're about to lose to a bloody Tenontosaurus. I'm going to go with my strong attack, just in case. I was tempted to go a little weaker, but I mean, it's worth just to bash his head in. Bosh his head in! There we go. Oh, it's the mirror matchup. Mine's prettier, though, for reasons. This bugs me, though, right? Look, why is his dinosaur faster than my dinosaur? It doesn't make any sense to me. I've thought it through. I've thought about it over and over again. Why would that lower level dinosaur be quicker than my dinosaur? I don't think it can be. And obviously you can't have multiple dinosaurs with different speeds because you only have one dinosaur of each type that you level up. You don't have like 10 Pikachus like you would in Pokemon Go. Let's try out... I wasn't going to pick... Apparently I took too long. I was the only one I wasn't going to pick. I was picking from two out of three and it picked the third one. It's completely my fault, but still. I think we're going to have to swap out. All I can think is that their speed is the same, which it obviously was because it's two Nodosauruses. And then what they've done is... I think I can take one more hit. Nice. Can I take a hit? Is that risky? We're going to go for it. It was a really good idea. Got loads of damage in there. Now we're going to swap to whoever's got the most health, which is the Proceratosaurus. Oh, and he swapped to a Raptor as well. That's good for me as well. He is quicker than me, but we can lower his attack. And then we can lower his speed as well, I believe. We don't need to do that, though, because it'll kill it. So we'll save that attack. I might be dead, though. Ah, no, because we lowered his attack. Only reason I didn't die, though. There we go! Bingo, bloody bango! Right, this dude's on low health, right? This isn't going to be a kill, though. I am going to lose one, unfortunately. Not even close. It doesn't really matter. As far as I can tell, there is no difference between winning with three or winning with two. And we get to play Vyutar Raptor. Look at that beauty. Goes first, big attack. Whatever, swap all you want, buddy. Not going to make a difference. Ram! That's pretty cool, right? But it's a really cool arena, right? We'll check at the end. We'll see what the next one is. You're going to be good to me this time? This is all my rares. So, yes, we got the Wahoo and we got a Tanon. I'm going to lead with the Procerata just because I think it's going to be my fastest dinosaur. And I'd like to try to get that early advantage. And I was correct. So, let's lower his damage nice and early. Nice! Right, we're going to save our slowing move because we just don't need it against his opponent. If he swaps to something quicker, then we'll do it. But for now, we can just keep bashing his face in, basically. Taking quite a bit more damage than I would have liked. Woo-hoo-hoo! Woo, boy! Woo. Oh, my star! Oh, that's got a lot of health, though. All three of my dinosaurs are quicker than it. What I think I'm going to do is take the hit, like lose my Procerata, do as much damage as I can, and lower the damage of that guy for my next dinosaur to, you know, take a softer hit, basically. Sometimes it's worth sacrificing your dinosaur. They're all quicker, we can go with anything. I want to go highest damage. Might be this Nunt. I don't know, I can't remember their attacks. We're going to go for the Wahoo! It's going to slow me down. Oh, interesting. Well, I can slow him back down, at least. Phagomizer is a quite strong attack as well. So, and we may as well lower his attack as well. Oop. Instant cripple. Does this do damage? I can't remember. It doesn't, does it? No, I really don't like that as a move. Like, I just wasted an attack there because he didn't even hit me. And because instant cripple only works for one turn. The only reason I can see why you'd ever want to do that is because maybe they've got an attack that you know is coming, like a really strong attack that you suspect is on the way, and you kind of want to build up. I'm going to have to swap here. Don't want to lose that second dinosaur before he's even lost one. Nodosaurus it is. Okay, really good moveset here, so we're going to roll with the defense, and then we're going to break him in half. Going to smash him! Don't hit for much, but very, very tough. You know, we're going to take 126, that's nothing. And this should hit really hard. Look at that beautiful stuff! I'm like an old hand at this, I tell you. And both of these attacks will now be up for whatever his next dinosaur is as well. He may swap here, they do like to do a little swap. I don't see the point after the first one, personally, but whatever. Come on, you little mongoose. Chop, chop. The world is on fire. Now is not the time to think. Often they'll make a weird mistake where they bring out a dinosaur that's already taken a beating, like this one. And then they'll swap again, when they could have swapped. Oh my god, hello. Oh, you're new. Right, I need the defense, thanks. But we now know his other two dinosaurs are both really low health, you know? And I've got at least one on absolutely full health, ready and waiting to do some damage. Oh, nice! Those armor-piercing attacks are really, really good. See, why is he swamped to Allosaurus when Allosaurus is going to die in one hit? If the AI was a little bit smarter, just a tiny bit smarter, I would have lost a lot more battles than I have, let's put it that way. Defense again. Because I'm a coward, won't deny. It's pretty good, this. We're going to be able to do it so I only lost one dinosaur in the whole thing. And now he's swapping again for no reason. Look at that. You didn't achieve anything. You died anyway, you fool. And now he's quicker, so I would have got my attack in and then get an attack in again. It's just silly. And does it go up in 400s after that? It does. We're actually not that far from the end. I don't know how the game scales, but we're like a third of the way through the entire battle system already, so... The game isn't even out yet, guys, but I'm excited to see Spinosaurus and stuff like that. And there's a Generation 2 T-Rex as well, which is actually only a rare, so it's easy to get, which is pretty cool. Okay, anyways, we're going to end it there. Thank you so much for joining me as per usual. If you are still wondering how you get hold of this game for yourself, I did upload a guide on Saturday. I will try to link that down below if I remember, which I definitely will not. And that should explain exactly how to do it, how to get hold of the game, how to get hold of a copy for yourself, even though it is not out in your country, because it's not out in like 99% of countries. It's out in like Canada and Australia. So you either freeze to death or you get eaten by spiders. That's about the only two options available to you. Thank you so much for joining me, ladies and gentlemen. Cheers, much love, as always. Bye-bye. Hey guys and girls, thanks for watching. YouTube has been my full-time job for years now, but the adpocalypse and YouTube's frustrating new monetization system are making it tougher to survive and keep all of my organs. If you want to help keep the channel alive, consider throwing a little pledge at my Patreon page. It's not at all expected, and by just watching this video, you've really helped me out. But if you feel like giving a little bit more, or you happen to be a Russian oligarch billionaire and want to support me, you can do so right there. Cheers.